Hello everyone in Medical Scribe. I'm Karar Haider, student at Baghdad Medical College. Today we will talk about the sebaceous gland. In the previous videos, we talked about the hair structure and the hair functions, which considered as the first element in the skin appendages. While today we will talk about the sebaceous gland. The sebaceous gland is a small, circular, beer-shaped structure, which exists in the dermis layer, which is the deep layer of the skin. This gland exists in the skin, either attached to the hair follicle, positioned between the hair follicle and the erector pili muscle, in which it secretes its product on the hair shaft, or attached directly to the hairless skin surface, such as the lips and the nipple. So it will secrete its product directly on the skin. These glands are abundant in the scalp and the face, while they didn't exist in the palm of the hand and the soles of the feet. Okay, the sebaceous gland, as we said, is a pear-shaped structure that's composed of sebocytes. These sebocytes produce sebum, which we will know it later. The gland will secrete sebum, as we said, either on the skin surface directly or on the hair shaft, depending on if the skin contains hair or hairless in that area. So the gland will secrete the sebum on the hair shaft mainly by the contraction of the erector pili muscle, because as we say, the sebaceous gland positioned between the hair follicle and this muscle. So when this muscle contracts, it will pull the hair to its side, so the gland between them will be squeezed. As a result, it will secrete some of its oily material on the hair shaft. And there is another way to secrete the sebum that we may explain it in videos later. Alright, now we have the sebum. The sebum is the oily material that is produced by the sebocytes in the sebaceous gland. This sebum is a mixture of fatty materials, which are the triglyceride, cholesterol, wax esters, and the squalene. Okay, this sebum has three main functions. Firstly, it helps in preventing bacterial and fungal infections because of the triglyceride and the proteolytic enzymes, so it has an antibacterial and antifungal function. The second function is to lubricate the skin, so it will make a thin oily layer on the skin surface that helps in preventing the friction which harms the skin. The third and the final function is to preserve the flexibility of the hair. So these were almost everything about the sebaceous glands. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.